We're going to do some beef stew on the fire pit in the Dutch oven, and we're going to use this beautiful London broil. You can use sirloin, you can use round steak, you can use anything you like because it's going to get tender in the Dutch oven. We're going to use some celery, some onion, a couple fresh ears of corn, some red potatoes. We got us some unsalted beef stock. Now, if you get the low sodium beef stock, it has actually more sodium than unsalted. So you got to be real careful and read the label if you're looking for unsalted. I use unsalted beef stock because I'm going to add other seasonings. We're going to use a little bit of olive oil to sear up our meat, some Worcestershire sauce. We're going to be using this A1 dry rub, cracked peppercorn on the beef, and we're going to throw in some sliced carrots, can of sweet peas, and a can of green beans. I got this tripod here. Now I got the large 60 inch tripod because it's got to go around. If you have a campfire or anything, make sure you get one that's tall enough tripod, because they make them in all different sizes, and there's all kinds of manufacturers that have different ones out there. I saw one on a net for 47 inches, and you know, that's just not going to be tall enough when you're stretching it out around either your campfire or your fire pit. So I got the 60 inch, and you can see how much room you got there. So we're going to go ahead and light this wood here, and we're going to let it burn down while we chop our vegetables and our meat. Take my matches. So you stack your wood and you put just a little bit of your lighter fluid on the wood, and that'll get it going. Okay, so we're using our Fiberware knife set. I'll put the link down in the description for my knife sets. I got a Cuisinart and a Fiberware. They're almost identical. So we're going to go ahead and cut up this London broil. Nice size stew chunks. You're going to cut across it, and then what we're going to do is we're going to cut it up about like that. Nice stew chunks. You know, it'll shrink up a little bit, but that'll give you a nice size morsel of meat there. Okay, so this recipe is going to be Brunswick stew. Now, there's a little fight over Brunswick stew. You got Brunswick, Virginia, and Brunswick, Georgia. And they both say that Brunswick stew started there. So, it goes way back. So, who knows whether it's a Virginia recipe or a Georgia recipe, but that's the battle over Brunswick stew. And our next stew recipe we're going to do is going to be Virginia stew. You know, I was looking for a name for my YouTube, and we're all about Virginia, and I said, well, you know, I'm going to call it Virginia stew, a mix of all kinds of stuff from all over Virginia. So what fitting for the name is to go ahead and make some Virginia stew. Now that's done with chicken. Old Virginia stew is done with chicken and a tomato base. So we're going to show you that recipe next time in the Dutch oven. I absolutely love this Simply Bamboo board. It's unbelievable. You know, you need one of these when you're dicing up vegetables. It's good to have one of these to scoop up your items and just throw it in your bowl. And I got a small fireplace grate, and I put my wood on top, light it, and eventually all those coals will go down between them two blocks, and that'll keep it contained and it'll keep it nice and hot. it works out really well. Tools that you'll need other than the tripod comes with a chain, is I got this coal rake. I use that on the smoker and the fire pit. I have this. This will actually take the whole pot off of the chain, and you can carry the pot like that by the handle. Of course, this is something to stir the wood around. A good shovel, got several of them, good shovel for moving some coals around, and then your lid lifter. So I just got this. Also, one of the other items I got, this is a thing that you can grab a hold of a log with. See that? That comes in a lot, handy a lot too. Like if you want to get smoked out in your eyes, if you want to pick up one that fell off. As soon as that fire dies down, it's getting there. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to take a little bit of olive oil. We're going to coat this meat just a little bit. Then we're going to put a little bit of our dry rub on it, our A1 cracked peppercorn. It's going to go all over that. And then we're going to carry this over to the fire pit. We're just going to put that on and let that sear. I got to grab my spoon that I left in the house. So let's go ahead and get this searing. Go ahead and get that searing. Let that sear. It won't take long, about 4 or 5 minutes. You pretty much have to have a utensil in both hands. I should have brought the tongs out so I could hold the pot steady. But you can even use that slotted to hold the pot steady. Okay. See what we got here. A couple more minutes, two more minutes, and then we'll add some Worcestershire sauce. Gonna pour probably 2 tablespoons in there. Okay, so now we're going to take our vegetables, corn, peas, carrots, onions, celery, potatoes, green beans. We're going to give that a little stir, just a little bit. Now we're going to put our stock in here. Alright, so put our lid on there. We got about 35 to 40 minutes. We're going to let that sit like that. There are several ways to thicken your stew. One is make a roux out of flour and butter, and that's what we're going to do. Two, cornstarch. Three, mashed potato flakes. Four, some really fine breadcrumbs. Or you can take some of your vegetables out, puree them up, and put them back in the stew. There's also some stew recipes out there that use yogurt to thicken it up. But we're going to take our little cast iron skillet, we're going to set it on top of this lid when it's time to thicken, and we're going to make a roux out of it. and then we're going to put that in our kettle. So let's go ahead and check this. Look at that. Isn't that something? Look at that meat. Potatoes. I know it doesn't take long for those potatoes either. They're probably done. 35 minutes. Isn't that absolutely stunning? So we're just going to check the potatoes. Oh, no, it's done. The potatoes gave that stew a little thickening itself. So we're going to go ahead and do our roux anyway. I don't think I'm going to put all of it in it though. Okay, so we're going to take our little pan and we're going to make a little roux. It's pretty hot really quick. It's almost too hot to handle this little skillet, but about 1 tablespoon of flour and 1 tablespoon of butter. You heat it up on there like that. See what it is here? Now since that's thick, it's starting to thick from those potatoes, we're just gonna put probably half of that in there. See how this does. That smells unbelievable. That should be all we need for this stew. Let me see. I might do the whole, I usually do the whole thing, but it's not too bad as it is. Let's just add a little bit more. When we cover that up, it'll all start to boil. Not gonna put it all in, it'll make it too thick, I think. Well, there we go. Total time's about 50 minutes. Give or take a minute or two. Let's go ahead and get us some of this. Let's get some of these vegetables out first. I can get around the chain. Some of that broth. See, that's the good stuff right there. Look at that. All right, so that's Brunswick stew in the Dutch oven on the fire pit. Look at that. You know that A1 spice? It's really good for stews. Well, there it is. Look at that meat. That's hot. Potatoes are absolutely falling apart. So we're going to go ahead and pull this thing off. So stay tuned. We're going to do chicken and dumplings. We're going to do old Virginia stew. We're going to do Dutch oven pizza. We're going to do a pot roast. We're going to do pork ragu. Oh. It's going to be a great summer. So for Tom's Manly Meals, Brunswick stew in the Dutch oven, I'm Tom Moore. Good luck to you. So to get that off of there, we're going to take this right here. We're going to take the chain with us. And so
set that down right there. We can even use that for our lid too. There we go. See them coals down there? That's a perfect way to do a full fire pit.